They say if you walk a few steps at Blue Beach, you will definitely find a fossil. I am really hoping I find one. All right, I definitely found one. But really, I just don't want to die. Not for this. Today, I'm spending the morning at Blue Beach in Avonport. It's just 20 minutes from my house, and I have never been to Blue Beach. In fact, someone suggested it to me last week after I visited Medford Beach for the first time. So thank you so much for that suggestion. There is a fossil museum here. Unfortunately, it is closed. However, I'm gonna head down to the beach because there are fossils here that are 350 million years old, and I've heard that you can't walk a few steps without seeing one.
They have a really good explanation of where we are, which is good for people like me, because I never know. So there's the Avon River. On the left side, there's saltwater marine. Then you've got the Falmouth Bridge, the causeway, and then a little sign that says, salmon die here. There's been a lot of protests about that. And unfortunately, I think they lost that protest.
What do you think about outhouses? Would you rather go in one or go outside? Let me know in the comments below. So you just walk down this short path to the beach. And this path is beautiful. You can hear the birds. I actually kind of wish there was more of a path, but I can see the beach right there. Before we start this beach walk, I feel like I need to give a disclosure. Last night, I did go online and I read a little bit about Blue Beach. However, I'm probably gonna get a lot of it wrong. So, in the description below, I'm going to link to the Blue Beach Fossil Museum. They have all the facts. So don't hold me to anything that I've said wrong, because I'm trying my best.
And right there, that's also Blomidon.
Let me give you a few facts about Blue Beach. So, it is 2 kilometers long, and it is home to fossils that are 350 million years old. And from a historical perspective, that is really important because apparently some of the fossils that they found here were from a time period that they had never found anywhere around the world. And so, while Joggins is known for its fossils in Nova Scotia, here, they are actually 40 million years older. And yet no one really knows about this place, including me, as of 1 week ago. I think that might be a fossil. It looks like there's some kind of imprint. Even if you don't read a lot about what is happening here at Blue Beach, there is one important thing to know. One, these cliffs, you need to stay away from them. So the general guideline is, however tall they are is how far you should walk out. So if they're 30 feet up, walk 30 feet out, or 50 feet up, walk 50 feet out. And that's because tons of rocks fall from them. And so you could really get hurt. And that's not surprising because if you look at all of the rocks on the ground here, they are just like little slivers of things. So it can be quite dangerous. The other thing to know is you must check the tide time. If you look up Hantsport tide times, today low tide is at 9, high tide is at 3. So I have plenty of time. However, It's very dangerous because if the tide's coming in and you aren't aware of it, you could get stuck between the water and these cliffs. You don't want to do that, especially if you're like me and you're alone. So check the tide time.
It's just amazing how we are still within the Minas Basin, and yet it looks so different. Like, this looks nothing like Medford Beach.
I will say this, I know that I said not to walk close to the cliffs, but I think you start to do it a little bit naturally. So I'm constantly telling myself, like, walk this way, walk this way. I don't want to die out here. You can also hear some of the rocks fall from time to time. You gotta stay away from there. I feel like the farther that you walk left, the easier it is to spot them, and you don't have to always be turning them down. I found this one, which I think it's a plant of some sort. Anyway, I have found another one.
So I think right there, it's called Lighthouse Point. It certainly looks like that's a lighthouse on it.
Once again, there is no one on this beach but me. Another empty Nova Scotia beach. So I am going to start walking back because the tide is coming in a little, which means I either need to get my feet muddy, which I did last week, don't want to do again, or I need to walk closer to the cliffs, and I don't want to die. What is really important about this place is that this was the spot where you can see fossils where amphibians were starting to form. So that part of history, which is crazy that it's here and that we still have fossils to show that and prove it. God, there's so much in Nova Scotia that we don't know about. I had hoped that I could fly my drone, but in order to do that, I have to get rid of all of this wind, which means going close to the cliffs. And I don't want to die for drone footage.
The nice thing about this beach is that it's actually quite easy to walk on because the rocks are so brittle. But it's quite an easy rock.
What an amazing morning. I just had such a great time. There's nobody around here, and I actually think when we're allowed to travel with people, I am still going to do this because getting out on my own and doing a little bit of discovery has just been really wonderful. That said, I need a suggestion for next week. So I wanted to go to Cape Split, but the new loop isn't open. If you know of a beach where there are some interesting things, that it's easy for someone to go solo, I would love to hear your suggestions.